Hi, this is Pavan. Welcome to technofiles.com. Today we are going to talk about editing a theme or a site live using Dreamweaver. So let's just talk about it. Basically, you need to have FTP credentials to edit any live website. When you sign up with a web host, it will provide you with cPanel account and FTP accounts. So if you have FTP accounts, you can edit your site live using Dreamweaver. So it may be Dreamweaver or it may be hosted using some other technology, whatever it is, content management system. So let's just proceed to Dreamweaver. Define a site under site window and give your site a name and give some local folder for it. Basically, you can define any folder here. Here's something I want to explain. There are two things. One is local server and other one is remote server. Local server is a server that is running on your PC, and remote server is a server that is running on the website, like the web host that have a server that will run your website. So basically these are the two things, local server and remote server. I have mentioned many times, like, you need to have local server set up in your PC because you can test your website in your system itself rather than testing it in the remote server. So I have one jam local server here. I have that in place, and this is the web folder for it. I am choosing that folder as path or a cache files that will update from the remote server. Basically, what Dreamweaver will try to do is it will download the dependency files to your local folder, and it will edit here, and it will write these files again to the production. So this is how it works. If you want to test it locally, you can test it locally if you have a local server as well. So that's the point I want to convey here. So select one local folder. Here I am choosing a web folder of XAMPP. I've selected that, and under the servers tab, this is the main setup that you need to do. Give your server a name, whatever name that can be, and connect using FTP. You can connect to your server using FTP or secured FTP or FTP over secured socket layer, FTP or an explicit encryption and implicit. These are the options that you have, but anyways, FTP, normal FTP would be enough, and you must have FTP address of your site. So basically, I am the one who defined my site, so I will be knowing my FTP credentials for my site. I can choose one, and for this to demonstrate this tutorial, I have created one random FTP address. First, let's test if it's working fine or not. So I'm testing my FTP path of my website, FTP address, FTP host of my website, if it's working fine or not. And it connected successfully to my website, so it's working fine. So I've created one username, random username. Let me test if it's working fine or not. So password is required. Okay, it connected successfully. That means the FTP credentials that I've just created is working fine. So let me give that credentials here. And you can test the FTP credentials from test here. So Dreamweaver connected to your web server successfully. So basically this is the part that you need to do. And web URL will be just www.technofilesup.com. This is your test path. Whenever you edit a file, it will try to access this path. Let's see how this is useful in next steps. So in the advanced tab, select server model as PHP MySQL, and once it is done, click save. So I want to use this server as even testing as per your requirement. Depends on your requirement, but anyways, I prefer having one more local servers. You can define one more local server like this. You can give local network and you can give local folder path and all, and define it as testing server. That's up to you. That means the testing will be done on this server. Once this is done, you can write it to the production. So this is called my production, or remote server. So basically now I want to use the same server as even the testing server, so I'm choosing that as testing as well. Once you click on save, it will update the site cache. Let it update, let it take its time. Meanwhile, I'll pause this video and I'll get back to you once this is done. It seems to be done very soon. I've resumed it back. So this is my local folder. As you can see, this is my local folder. See users public documents amp htdoc something. It is a path. You can see here view, local view, remote server view, testing server view, and repository view. Since remote server and testing server are same, as soon as I select remote server, it will connect to your web server and it will fetch the pages from there. So it is connecting to Technofiles Hub using FTP credentials. So since it is connected, you can see all the files in your server, and you can go to your web server and you can go to the content directory. Because I'm using WordPress, it will be WP content, and under the themes you have to select themes, and basically you have, I don't know which theme I'm using now. Okay. Anyways, choose one theme and select index.php of that theme. Reviewer currently interacting with the server. Why it is interacting, man? Waiting for server. It's nothing. Basically, you need to select this particular file. It is somehow it is dependent on the web server. It is waiting for some server actually. Now, as soon as you click on index.php, it will ask you to get the dependent files as well. So select yes to get all the dependent files as well. Now, these files will be placed in your local folder. In your local folder, this page may have dynamically content. Just click on discover as of now here. So this will update the file on the testing server. Now, since the testing server is same as the production server, that means it will update the file in the FTP server. So put dependent files as well. You select yes. And 1 minute. It's a little late here. It's taking a little time. Okay, no problems. So live code. Switch on live code and in live view. Here, what you have to do is, as you can see, the path updated here will be http://www.technofileshub.com, WP content, themes, and technofileshub index.php. In this way, it will access the web server, but what you can do is you can directly access your website. Since the live view is selected, the live web page will be loaded in the right side pane. It depends on the resolution. My site will change based on the resolution. So basically, this is how we access our live site. You can see the properties responsible for it. If you switch to design view, you'll see your site in complete view, and you can see all the properties that are responsible for giving this, like Here we have color as this thing. If you want to change the color, if you change the color to some random color and apply and click OK, unable to open because it could not be found on your local disk. Basically, there will be dependencies that you know that needs to be downloaded and have to be worked. What I'll tell is you have to create a testing server and you have to download the theme from there to here, and you know the dependency files will be automatically downloaded by Dreamweaver to your local site, and you can you know take on the development from there. So that's what I suggest, and but you know this is the way that we connect to a live website. Hope you found this useful, and thanks for watching. Have a nice day.